Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you are safe and doing good. Before going into the next topic, let's have a recap. Okay. What is force? Force is the action of push or pull, which brings the bodies, moving bodies at rest. It makes the bodies to move. That is called force, is it? Okay. So, what are the definition of forces? The force that which changes or tends to change the state of rest, state of uniform motion, the direction of the moving body, or change of the shape of the object, or called the, or all these are the definition of force. Okay. So, thrust. What is thrust? The force is perpendicularly acting on the surface area of the given object. Isn't it? Surface area of the given object. That is called thrust. What is the unit of thrust? Newton is the unit of thrust. Okay. The next word is that pressure. What is pressure or defined pressure? The amount of force or the thrust acting perpendicularly on the surface area for the square meter of an object. That is called pressure. What is the unit of pressure? Newton per meter square or Pascal. Okay. But next we are going to see the forces in liquids. In that you are going to see the buoyant force of a liquid. What is buoyant force? See here that here you are seeing the arrow. This is called upward force. Okay. The upward force helps the bodies to float or partially submerge the body. That upward force, no? That is called buoyant force. Okay. Buoyant force. Okay. You see here, upward forces is exerted by the water. This is water. Okay. Fluid. Okay, upward forces exerted by the water on the floating, this object is floating or partly submerged, partly sink. Okay, that is called buoyant force. Okay, then this force is not only exerted by the liquid. We are thinking that the force only acting upon the liquid, not. It's not only upon the liquid, on it, upon the gases also. It acts upon gases also. Okay, these liquid and gases are together called as fluids. So, what are the two things are together called as fluids? Liquids and gases. You can see here, fluids are called, liquids and gases are together called as fluids. And then the next one is, what is buoyancy? So, what happened here? This is buoyant force. This force, we said the buoyant force, the phenomenon, what all that happened, no? It all called buoyancy. So, what is buoyancy? The ability, that the character, no? That upward force, the ability to float the things on, the bodies on the water. That the ability to float, that is buoyancy. The next, we are going to see the buoyant force. What is this? The upward force, isn't it? The upward force decides. This upward force only decides whether the object will float or sink. Here you can see that. This upward force decides whether the object will sink or float. You can see here. Here the weight is greater than buoyancy force. The body will sink. Is sinking? Yes. The weight is greater than the buoyancy force. Buoyant force, body will sink. The buoyant force is greater than the weight, body will float. Here the body is floating. Okay, see here. Weight of the object is less than, the weight is less than the upward force, object will float. Okay, but if the object weight is greater than the upward force, no? This only help the object will float or sink, we said. This force only decides the object will sink or float. So, this force, decides. If the weight is greater than this force, so the object will sink. Okay. The buoyance force is greater than its weight. Body floats. If the weight is greater than the buoyant force, the body will sink. Do you understand, children? Yes. Next, we are going to see the pressure exerted by liquids. Here, you can liquids do not have any shape. Then we are going to see the static pressure of the liquid. Force acting on one unit area of the surface on which the liquid placed. Okay, that is called the static pressure of the liquid. And then the pressure exerted by liquids, not only the base of the container but the sides of the wall. It's not showing the base of the container but the sides of the wall. The same way it's the pressure exerted by liquid is also the depth of the point, depth of the liquid. So it is based on the depth of the pressure exerted by liquid is also based on the depth of the point. What is this? This is the instrument name called manometer. It is used to measure the difference between the pressure of the liquids. It is used to measure the difference between the pressure of the liquid. Instrument is named called manometer. You can also measure the liquid in the closed container using the instrument manometer. Okay. Now you are going to do one activity. What you are going to see? One activity. First you take the glass tube. You are taking the glass tube that is open with both the ends. And one of the end you are placing the balloon. One of the end you are placing the balloons. In that you are adding water. So you are pouring water into it and observe the water level. And then again you are pouring the water and then observes. What happened? The balloon starts to bulge. So when you are adding water, here he is blowing the water, it is bulging, it comes big, isn't it? So like that, when you are pouring the water, what will happen? The balloon bulges, start to bulge. It increases width and increase the height of the water column. So when the balloon bulges increases, when the height of the water column increases. Okay. So that it shows that the pressure exerted by the liquid, not only base of the container, depends on the height of the liquid column. Height of the liquid column. Okay, that's the first point. And then the second, pressure varies with depth. Now you take one water bottle, okay, or container, and then make three holes on it. You have to make the three holes in one direction. It's the same direction. One is here, not one is here, not like that. You have to punch the holes on the same direction. Okay. But it in the different height, not in the same height, in the same side. You have to punch it in the different heights of that. Then you have to observe, pour the water and leave the water on the holes and then observe it. So what will you observe? You are seeing the depth of the point. You know, that points the water falls on the maximum distance. Here you can see that the water is falls on the maximum distance. But in the first hole, on the top of the hole, it falls on the minimum distance. It's near to the bottle itself. It's falling that. Okay. So what it will shows that this activity confirms you that. This activity confirms that the pressure of liquid varies with the depth of the point. Observe it, isn't it? Here, this is the last point. What will happen? It flows. The greater pressure and close to the distance, no, maximum distance it's flowing. So we learn that, no, it is also depend on the pressure. We exerts pressure depends on the depth of the container, depth of it. So it only goes fast, no? Maximum distance. The water flows in the maximum distance. Yes? Do you understood that? Pressure of water increases with depth. Can see here the liquid pressure varies with the depth of the point. Okay, so the next activity we can see that. Okay, here you can take the bottle and then make your holes on the same height of the bottles, same height but in the different direction. You have to make your holes on that. Then what will happen? Then after that you pour water and the water flows in all the holes. And you can observe that the water flows, you know, so the depth of the height is same. No, all the holes have the depth of the height is same. Now you are seeing that the all that directions the flowing is same. Yes, the water flows is same in all directions. So what do you observe that? Confirm exert the same pressure in all directions. So this this activity shows that the pressure exert pressure in all direction. So do you clear children now? Okay, now you said liquid exert pressure in all the direction at a given depth. Okay, these three the factors includes the pressure exerted by liquids. See here that first we see that one experiment. The experiment shows that base of the container depends upon the height of the column. Yes, that water column. You'll observe that. Then the second one says that second experiment. Liquid pressure varies with the depth of the container. We have take the water bottle and make a three holes on the sides of that. You know, varies with the depth of the container. And then the third one, holes in water bottle in all direction. No, that we have to say that liquid exert pressure in all direction at a given depth. So the water flows in all the direction. Same pressure is flows on that. If the depth holes is different, so the it is depend upon the pressure varies with the depth of the point. Okay, it's clear. Good. Next, we are going to see the Pascal law. Okay, now you take the rubber bowl and pour water inside it with water, and then you close the rubber bowl. And then make a hole on the surface area of the ball. Okay. Then you can press at any one point. Here I am giving the external pressures. So what happened? There are identical stream of water is flowing continuously on all the sides direction, isn't it? From the holes. So identical stream of water flowing in all direction. Yes. So you are seeing here the water is flowing on all direction of this. So this is due to the phenomenon that the pressure is applied on the one point, but it is equally transmitted in all direction. The pressure is transmitted on one point, but it is equally transmitted in all direction. Okay. So what is the Pascal law? Define Pascal law. Pressure applied on one point of liquid, but it transmit it equally in all direction of that. Now you are going to see the application of Pascal law. Pascal law. Okay. So what is here? The car is lifting up with a hydraulic lift. Yes. So this is work according to the Pascal law. Here you can see in an automobile service station we are using this Pascal law. The vehicles are lifted upward using the hydraulic lift. So here the Pascal law is used to lift the hydraulic the car. What is the next? Then the automobile brake systems, okay, works on according to Pascal law. The automobile brake system is also work according to the Pascal law. Then the next one here, the hydraulic press. You are pressing here to make your small compressed bundles of cotton or cloth. So it's occupy less space of that. Here also it is used to the Pascal law. These are the applications of Pascal law. Do you understand, children? Yes, good. Let's have a recap. The upward forces exerted by the water on the floating or submerged body. Upward force decides whether the object will float or sink. Then the pressure exerted by a liquid on the base of the container depends upon height of the liquid column. Next, we learned what is Pascal law. The pressure applied at any point of a liquid at rest in a closed system will be distributed equally through all region of the liquid. Next, we learn the application of Pascal law. It is used in automobile service station. It is used in the automobile brake system. Children, do you all understand? Yes. We will meet in the next class. Until then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you, children.